अस्सलाम वालेकुम एवरीवन, आई एम मोहम्मद कामरान मलिक, प्रिंसिपल किम्स। द पर्पज़ ऑफ दिस वीडियो एंड द पर्पज़ ऑफ फोर्थ कमिंग वीडियोज इज़ टू शेयर इंफॉर्मेशन विच वी हैव गैदर्ड ओवर ईयर्स ऑफ एक्सपीरियंस। आई बीन अप्रोच बाई पेरेंट्स एंड स्टूडेंट्स एंड टीचर्स एज वेल रिगार्डिंग वेरियस क्वेश्चंस। आई थॉट इट इज़ बेटर that I record my views in the form of a video and upload them on our YouTube channel as well as put them on our Facebook page. So you are requested to kindly subscribe our YouTube channel as well as follow our Facebook page and keep looking for updates. I assure you that the videos you will find on our channel and on our Facebook page will be of interest to you and they will give you some useful information. Today's topic, the topic of today's video, is about O-level, the duration of O-level. Normally, students do O-level in Lahore at least, and other parts of the country, in 3 years. But there is a debate whether 3 years is an optimal period of time for an O-level student or it should be of 2 year duration. My point of view is that O-level should be done in a 2 year period of time. Now why I say that? I say it because A-level is more difficult. There is nothing new about this. A-level is supposed to be more difficult. It is a higher level, it is advanced level. My other argument, you may say that this argument is nothing new in this, but this is not a cliche to say A-level is more difficult. I will say it with some facts and figures. I'll quote some numbers to tell you that A-level is far more difficult than O-level and O-level is far more easy than A-level, and there are reasons for that and those reasons are quantitative. First, I'm not quoting the figure from my own judgment, I am quoting the official document of Cambridge International, which has actually articulated the syllabus of both O and A level. On every syllabus document of O level subjects, it is mentioned that Cambridge recommends 130 guided learning hours for one O level subject, whereas same Cambridge International recommends 360 teaching or guided learning hours for one A-level subject. First, we talk about O-level. Normally, students do 8 O-level subjects. If we follow the guidelines of Cambridge and we provide 130 teaching hours for one O-level subject, there are total 1040 teaching hours that are needed. That is 130 multiplied by 8. Total hours needed for O-level, teaching hour needed for O-level are 1040. Whereas for A-level, Cambridge recommends in written form, it is written on every syllabus document of A-level subjects, 360 hours. Normally students do 3 A-level subjects. 3 into 360, it is 1080 teaching hours. So, it is not rational to me, it is not rational to give 3 years to O-level program whose teaching total teaching hours are 1040 and give just 2 years to A-level whose teaching hour are 1080. Just imagine, A-level students are expected to raise their speed or the work burden on them is around 40% higher because they are doing 1040 hour course in 3 years and they are expected to do 1080 hour course in 2 years time. Most of the students cannot cope up with this challenge, and that is why we see many students struggling at A-level. My other argument in the favor of 2 years O-level program is that previously in Pakistan, when graduation was of only 2 years, we could afford the luxury of giving one more year to O-level and one extra year for O-level. Even with 3 years at O-level, we could have completed our graduation in 15 years. That is 11 years O-level, 2 years A-level, 13, and 2 years graduation. But now, when our graduation is of international standard and we need to spend 4 years in our graduation, students of Pakistan will end up completing, I will need 17 years to complete their graduation. They'll be 1 year behind their international, the students doing graduation from other parts of the country, other parts of the world. Other parts of the world, they are doing graduation in 16 years, we'll be doing it in 17 years. Secondly, compared to matric, maybe there are two students in a family. One is very bright, one is a mediocre. Mediocre is suggested to do matric. The brighter one is asked to do O-level. Normally we do that. We think O-level is difficult compared to matric. So mediocre student goes for the route of matric. And the better student goes for the option of O-level. Now what happens? That the matric student completes graduation in 16 years and the O-level students complete, the brighter one, the so-called brighter one, takes one more year. He is lagging behind the studies. Now that is such a strange thing that you are asking mediocre student to do something in 16 years and asking the brighter one do it in 17 years. My next argument, 2 years O-level puts enough pressure, adequate pressure on students to take their studies seriously, and it prepares them well for their A-level education. Let me tell you that the 2 years, 3 years O-level program not only waste time, one pressure is wasted. Not only it results in the wastage of one precious year, it also puts enormous financial burden on parents, and parents have to pay a fee of one extra year. Third, O-level students, when they do O-level of 1040 guided hours in 3 years, they get wrong signals about the challenges and difficulties of A-level. They enter A-level without much preparation. They enter A-level unprepared with wrong expectations. And that means the foundation to do A-level is not properly established. My other discussion, in O-level, schools give around 300 teaching hours. I assume that 4 hours per week, 32 weeks per year, and you exclude months for holidays, so roughly 300 hours, teaching hours are provided to students for one O-level subject. Requirement, 130 hours. Suggested requirement, of course, Cambridge doesn't say exact 130. Cambridge says approximately 130. But when they say and they recommend 130 hours, we provide 300 hours. In A-level, Cambridge recommends 360 hours, and we give only 225, approximately, plus minus. Now, A-level students find it immensely difficult to cope up with A-level challenges. They find this problem because in O-level, they have probably been spoon-fed 300 hours compared to 130. In A-level, 225 compared to 360. It's not a surprise for me, at least, that most of the students find A-level extremely difficult. So my suggestion, do not waste your time, do not waste your money, and get proper preparation by opting for a 2 year O-level program. One may argue that O-level in 2 years will be difficult. Let me tell you, with my experience of over 25 years, you can do O-level in 2 years easily. If you struggle in O-level of 2 years, 2 year O-level program, you will probably struggle in a 3 year program as well and a 4 year program as well. 2 years are enough. Our school offers O-level in 2 years. I am willing to meet your parents, I am willing to meet you, and will discuss or can give you answers for if you have any questions. And my suggestion and my strong recommendation that O-level should be of 2 years. Thank you very much for your time.